Well, now we want to turn to the French Quarter. That's where police are investigating three separate crimes over the weekend. WDSU anchor LaTanya Norton explains two of the incidents turned deadly. LaTanya?
That's right, Camille. We're coming off of a very bloody weekend in the historic French Quarter. We're talking about three crimes in roughly 27 hours. Now, the first one happened Monday morning. The first one happened Sunday morning about 3:30, where decorated Marine Sergeant Ryan Lakowski of Metairie was stabbed to death at the intersection of Dauphine and Iberville Streets. The second crime happened Monday morning about 1 o'clock. Police say a 20-year-old man was shot in the head in the 100 block of Bourbon Street. Now, as we speak, he is still fighting for his life. And hours later, at 6:30 a.m., police found the body of a shooting victim at the corner of Burgundy and St. Louis Streets, wrapping up, as I said, a very violent weekend in the historic French Quarter, Camille.
Yeah, I can imagine, LaTanya, a lot of folks there rattled or alarmed. What are they saying to you?
We spent part of the day in the French Quarter. We talked to tourists there, visitors there, people who live there and work there, and all of them told us the same thing. They say they just don't see enough police visibility. They say anytime you see police in the area, it's an automatic deterrent of crime. They say there's not enough police on the streets. They say police drive around all the time, but they feel there's not enough police officers on the streets, and they'd like to see something done about it. We should also mention that the New Orleans Police Department tells us that more police officers are in the historic French Quarter than any other part of the city, Camille.
And LaTanya, curious enough, all of this comes weeks after voters in the French Quarter decided against that referendum for extra security there in the French Quarter.
That's right. We were curious as to whether or not they felt that they regretted that that vote did not go through, if hindsight is 20/20. But we were told that, you know, from people who say that they did not vote for it, that they are still against it. They say they have enough tax dollars. They don't want to pay more for private security patrols. They feel like the tax dollars are there, the police are there. They just have to do more to utilize their resources more wisely, Camille.
All right, LaTanya, coming up tonight at 5 o'clock, more of what visitors in the quarter had to say. And we'll also hear from WDSU crime and safety specialist Howard Robertson.